Hey, it's Noel Christopher. I'm going to try to start doing some more of these short, quick videos here. I got away from it a little bit. Give you a little background. What I'm trying to do is I'm really trying to dominate this build for rent space. And I think I've been onto something. Besides my commentary about the housing market, where I think things are going with the economy, really what I do is transaction based. And pre-COVID, I had a great pipeline of homes going. I was actually probably a little too comfortable, and COVID hit and everything just kind of went down the tube. So I've spent the last 3 months figuring out how to resurrect the transactions that I had and being really, really creative. And what I found is that nothing's really dead if you can have some creativity. And that's something that we figured out, how to work with builders, be very creative, and start really building a pipeline. When I'm talking about a pipeline, I'm talking about homes going into 2021. The single family rental space is very much alive, and I believe will be alive going forward. And I've had a lot of time to reflect and figure out what I need to do personally to not only just provide for my family and be successful, and that's all great, but really be an expert in this space and really dominate being someone who is a go-to person in the build for rent space. And what I've been doing, you know, for example, today I had a great conversation with an investment banker that works with builders, works with raising money for some build to rent investors. And we had a great conversation because a lot of people are looking at the build for rent communities and they're looking at build for rent from the large builders. What I'm really focusing on is the build for rent for the smaller private builders. Any builder that does anything from 100 homes, 50 homes a year to 3,000 homes a year, and creating or really de-risking themselves in the market as they all start to go to the more affordable markets. The same thing with the population, the migration patterns that have accelerated the last few months. We're seeing the builders want to get into these spaces as well. So I'm going to start documenting this journey a little bit. Shout out to Greg Rand, who has kind of put a challenge for me to really take a little bit more ownership of what I'm trying to do in the space, how I'm trying to become more relevant and bring a lot of attention and credibility and profitability to some of these builders who they're starting to see. They had really great months. They had a great June, a great, great, great May. Some of them had record months. But what they're not doing is they're not putting the foot back on the accelerator. They're still being conservative because they don't know what's going to happen with the spikes in cases, with COVID, with home ownership going forward. And working and partnering with these funds and being creative about doing it is a great solution, because for every entry-level build-to-rent home, entry-level new construction home, there's a need for that same home to be a rental. So people look at the home ownership rates and all of that, but when you start looking at the lower, more affordable homes, something I mentioned before, there is a need for rentals. So we're really partnering with these builders who are looking at this now and saying, if I want to build a diverse community that's going to last into the future, I need to think about not only homeowners, higher density, a multifamily or higher density housing, retail, commercial, and single family rentals is just as important to build this diverse communities. So just want to throw that out there. You know, if you're a builder and you're trying to figure out unique ways and you're having liquidity problems or you're not sure what to do in the future, contact me, because we've really come up with some interesting and innovative ways to make this build for rent space work that takes risk away from the builder, takes risk away from the fund, and they can buy at scale. Like, comment, share. I appreciate you, those who watch and those who comment on and contact me and tell me they like my content. And that's all I've got for today. I'll talk to you tomorrow.